Good morning, grade 7. How are you? I hope you are doing well. My name is teacher Haleen. I will be your science teacher for this semester. Let's start by opening our books and reading together the first lesson in unit 1. Now, open your books to page number 6 and 7. Our first lesson is the importance and principles of classification. Before we start with the importance and principles of classification, we have to know what is classification. Now, in page number 7, let's read importance of living things classification, the last paragraph in the page. Thousands of years ago, people recognized the presence of different groups of living things. They noticed that some animals had claws and sharp teeth and roamed the land. Others had feathers and beaks and flew in the air. Still, others had scales and fins and swam in the water. So, from this paragraph, we know that animals are different and living things are different in many ways, how they move, how they look, how they eat, how they live, where they live. So there are many features and many grounds on which we can classify animals. Now, according to their observations, people developed simple systems of classification. Now, what is classification? This is very important. Please pay attention. That's why I summarized everything in this PowerPoint. Classification, التصنيف, is a term that refers to grouping of living things according to similar features. So, we put things into group. As you can see in those pictures, we put things into group. Here, you can see that there are red people, yellow people, and green people, each in their own group. Here, green pentagons and red dots, yellow stars, we put them into groups. So classification means, so why is classification important? Why is it important? It's very important because, number one, it helps provide a better understanding of living things. So it makes us understand living things better. So we can say that it makes us, between brackets, makes us understand living things in a better way, better, in a better way, okay? Number two, it allows scientists to know about a living thing by knowing the features of its group. So we agreed that each group has features. لكل group خصائصه. So it makes us understand the living thing and know about it through the group. For example, when I say cats are mammals, for example, okay. When I say cats are mammals. So mammals, ثدييات, القطط, ثدييات, cats are mammals. When I say that, you understand that cats give birth, تلد, ليس طبيد, doesn't lay eggs. And you understand that cats feed their littles milk, ترضع صغارها. You understand that cats have four legs, they live on land, بيعيشوا على الأرض, عندهم رجلين, they don't live in the water. So, by knowing the group, you know the features of the animal. Now, classification of living things, there are several kingdoms. Okay. How are living things classified? How do we classify living things? Scientists discovered that nowadays they can classify living things into 6 kingdoms. This is very important. If I ask you how many kingdoms are there, you have to answer with 6 kingdoms. Kingdoms are large and general groups. And of course, also kingdoms are divided into smaller groups. What are the six kingdoms? Animals, plants, fungi, protists, ibobacteria, archaebacteria. Look at this picture. These are the six kingdoms of life, as they say. Animalia, animals, plants, fungi, اللي هو الفطر, protists, they are أحاديات الخلية, ibobacteria, أنواع من أنواع البكتيريا اللي هي حندرسها بعدين, and archaebacteria. So there are three types, هدول بيعيشوا على الأرض, and هدول أحاديات الخلية معظمهم ما بنقدر نشوفهم with our own eyes. اللي هي كائنات دقيقة التكوين. They are not complex. They are not complex living things. They are primary, بدائيات. So, what do we need to know at the end of this class? Let's do a revision. The classification. What is classification? A term that refers to grouping of living things according to similar feature. Why is it important? Because it makes us understand the living things in a better way, also allows science to know about living things by knowing the features of its group. What are the six kingdoms? I want you to know only three of these six kingdoms. And this semester, we will only study animals and plants. Maybe if you pursue, if you study biology more, you will know more about bacteria and all of that. But for now, know only three or four of the six kingdoms. But you have to know that they are six kingdoms. So this is the first lesson. Of course, I summarized it. هذا تلخيص. This is a summary of this lesson. This is the most important things that you need to learn. And until next time, I will see you next week. Inshallah, goodbye grade 7. If you have anything to ask me, you can do that by sending your questions on WhatsApp and I will be happy to answer them. Goodbye.